Did you know if you drop a like and subscribe in the next 5 seconds, nothing will happen, but it will put a giant smile on my face. The Fortnite V17.20 update is approaching fast, and with that said, we have a ton of things to cover before it does, or what's going to be contained within it, such as a new event to earn free rewards, a potential cup to earn the brand new LeBron James Icon Series skin despite Cosmic Summer just ending, where it allowed us to earn all of these free rewards. And not only that, we have a brand new in-game live event, or something that's going to be changing the map drastically happening anyways, whether it is one or not, and just overall a ton of interesting things to go over this video that you guys perhaps didn't know about or missed, so make sure you're sticking around and watching the full thing, as my dog says right here. Gus would just like to thank you all for showing all the love that you do on the videos, and yeah, just thinking he's cute and stuff, which he is, he's like a loaf of bread. Before we dive into it all, however, emergency red card has been pulled by the 6-foot banana, which of course means, yes, you need to subscribe to the channel. We don't make the rules, sadly, this 6-foot banana, potassium filled, does. And he's now teamed up with the Fishy Boys to form the Mutant Squad. The alliance has been formed, the war is now over and not being waged, and the Mutant Squad consists of every mutated character on screen right now. Despite staying up to date with everything in the world of Fortnite, being a part of the Mutant Squad has its benefits, as I gift different or 5 subscribers every single day. So of course, if you want to receive something in the next video, make sure to let me know what that might be in the comment section down below, whilst you're subscribing and turning on notifications, and then commenting your Epic Games ID down below too. And yeah, this could be you in the very next video, surprised with something, whether it's the Battle Pass or an item shop cosmetic. But anyways, we've wasted enough time now, let's hop into a game and discuss everything you guys need to know on the lead up to 17.20, what's going to be included within it, and honestly, so much juicy intel, so make sure you don't go anywhere.
Don't go anywhere.
Okay, so perhaps one of the first things I want to discuss is, well, yep, this giant thing in the sky right here. As you guys may or may not know, this shadow resembles, like, the edge of the mothership, or where it's hovering over currently, if that makes sense. And despite this happening to the middle of the map, yes, in the Chapter 2 Season 7 cinematic trailer where, yes, the Spire was abducted, maybe the Zero Point exploded or not, but either way, the Spire definitely did, as the shards are all around there. And since then, we don't know the whereabouts of the Zero Point, however, the Batman Zero Point comics obviously develop a storyline and try and give us an indication of where it is. After all, for those that don't know, each Fortnite island, yes, does need a Zero Point, as it's the heart of everything that Galactus did want to devour in the Chapter 2 Season 4 live event, The Devourer of Worlds. But anyways, without getting too off track, obviously Coral Castle is the point of interest where we're mainly thinking that this is going to end up next. Oh my god, my sound was so loud. Literally sounded like this dude was breaking through my bedroom. Not today. If you haven't been keeping track of the mothership, here is kind of like a direct route it's taken over the days that Season 7 has been a thing or been live in Fortnite, with this bigger than the map spaceship, yes, hovering above our map in itself. Honestly, the end of this season, it might seem slow right now. It's going to be huge, I'm just telling you. Whatever happens in terms of an event build up to a next cinematic, like a Zero Crisis finale kind of event that we can play as soon as the season loads up for the first time when it's updated, it's going to be crazy. But yeah, in terms of the movement of this, as you can see, it's mainly gone anti-clockwise, like all the way around reverse to Coral Castle, from what a clock would rotate, hence the term anti-clockwise. And data miners have managed to discover not only there is a destroyed Coral Castle kind of version of this name location in the files, but it looks like this is going to be coming very, very soon. The reason for this being is because not only is it like right near Coral Castle, this shadow now resembling the edges of the mothership, meaning, yeah, this middle point where it's going to abduct it maybe is kind of near it. But data miners have managed to discover in the files there is also an animation for this opening, kind of like we saw in the trailer, but we can't see it now because of the storm. Again, when it abducted the Spire, exploded it, and left all the shards in the middle of the map with no Zero Point on the island anymore. And as for when we can expect to see this abduction, whether it happens live in game randomly as like a mini event, oh wait, there's the hatch, or whether it happens in stages with this hatch soon opening, as data miners have found obviously leaked gameplay of or stages of happening in terms of the mothership's development, I guess we're yet to know. But finally, for once, we're actually in the circle for the first time. Realistically, I guess we're yet to know, but let's visit this name location before it is destroyed, considering it is going to be. Like I said, we have these textures of the destroyed version of it in the files, and when we can be expecting this to be coming is obviously with the brand new update, as Epic Games did go on vacation as soon as Cosmic Summer went live, for like this duration anyways on screen right now. I think they're back in office right now, but I think they're also giving it another week before they update anything. Wait, what is going on over here? Why did I drive into the water? Earn that health. What do you got to offer? Gonna sweat it out. I don't need any health. I'd just like to hold the chug splash, please. Does she just give us infinite amounts of health? Not gonna lie, that's kind of cool. But yeah, despite Epic Games already getting back off vacation, obviously they need to prep things in advance, because Fortnite do that, are Epic Games. They work way in advance, have plans way for the future, or things upcoming scheduled. And it looks like we may have to wait like another week or so to see the 17.20 downtime update occur, as we've only seen one after the seasonal update this season, being 17.10. I'm guessing these guys are making the most of this named location before it's gone. To be honest, this area kind of already looks destroyed-ish. I remember when everyone was saying this is going to be Atlantis and stuff like that, because it was meant to be revealed underneath the water in Chapter 2, Season 3, which mobile players are still stuck in, and I feel bad for you. What's this guy doing? You're not going to survive down there. The storm's coming in. You're in a ditch. Was not happening.
A llama.
Today on Animal Watch, we have this llama that we're going to chase. Can we destroy it before it starts stops pooping out loot and teleports? This might be one of the first times I've done this if I can manage it.
It is success.
And we got a replenishing exotic, what is it called again?
Jug cannon.
Honestly though, I'm not really too sure how this is going to work if the update is around July 20th, and Fire Monkey's usually dead bang on about this stuff, or correct anyways. As around July 14th, as you guys know, the street artist teased what we now know to be a LeBron James collaboration or Icon Series skin coming for a brand new event called the King's Bling event, where we can earn rewards related to basketball, LeBron James, or even the Lakers. And it's confirmed now that he will be coming as an Icon Series skin. Sadly, data miners haven't been able to reveal what he'll look like yet in Fortnite, but my 3D designer who makes my thumbnails, shout out to EA, he already made a concept of what he believes it will look like and correlate to, considering on July 16th, there is a new Space Jam film releasing. Also, Tim Sweeney, the CEO of Epic Games, or founder or whatever, tweeted out something in relation to Looney Tunes. What is going on in here? We're already Mutant Squad, we don't need another mutation on our head. Oh no. It transferred down Deadpool, you tricked me. And yeah, with the release of this brand new Space Jam film, if you haven't seen the original with Michael Jordan, I highly recommend it because it's such a good film. Like, just a classic, to be honest. Not only is it releasing July 16th, but we're most likely going to be getting an Icon Series LeBron James selectable style for the Tune Squad, I think it says on his shirt. And with the arrival of this, despite the free rewards we can get in the King's Bling quest that Hypex managed to find in the files, are going to be a thing, like, literally going live when, you know, this event actually starts, that the street artist tease on July 14th. Considering other Icon Series skins are earned for free, like, you know, Lachlan, then we also had the Gref G, Laserbeam, so who knows, maybe we can earn the LeBron James Icon Series skin for free, and maybe it comes with a brand new creative mode that we have to do this in, kind of like we got creative quests for Cosmic Summer, but yeah, this would be like a creative mode related to basketball, as Epic Games had been working on this themselves. This again was leaked in the Apple versus Epic court trial relating to Fortnite Mobile, alongside even initially the LeBron James skin being a thing potentially in the fourth quarter, I think it was, of 2020. Who ticked off an alien? This is my trespasser to annoy nobody else. There's many like it, but this one is mine. Oh wait, what's this do? I haven't used one of these yet. Oh my god, it makes everywhere kind of like Holly Hatches. Look at that, that looks so cool. How many trespassers is there in here? We just kind of teamed a trespasser and now you're dead. Look at all the loot. Another trespasser, really?
So many this game.
Anyways, as soon as LeBron James is revealed in terms of a skin or the cup that we can earn him for free early, as this usually is the case before it rotates in the shop, if we can earn them in a cup, I'll have that covered on my Twitter, linked in the video description down below, and we're incredibly close to 10,000 followers, so make sure to go follow me over there for instant Fortnite updates. But in terms of something else that's coming to an end, and something interesting perhaps leading off from it, is the storyline portrayed through the Batman Zero Point comics. The reason this is interesting is because of not only the content, like, actually in the sixth issue itself out of six, and bearing in mind, if you got these comic books, they all came with a code in each for an individual free reward, of which are all in order on screen right now, but if you redeem all six codes from all the comic books, congratulations, you got the Armored Batman Zero skin for free. And the reason this is interesting is because not only will it, like, set up a mystery for the storyline now, perhaps, even though it's kind of cryptic portrayed in these comic books. Sorry, Mr. Lonely IO Guard, you're gonna have to take a hit. But as I was going to say about the Batman Zero Point comics, obviously, with this being the DC universe involved with Fortnite, this doesn't mean that DC aspects of Fortnite's collaboration anyways or integration are over, as Donald Mustard a while ago was actually teasing Wonder Woman in the background of one of his videos. There's been many other hints about Wonder Woman upcoming as a skin eventually too that data miners have managed to find, and I'll put the tweet on screen if I can find it by Sheena. I know I've definitely seen it though, and I know Sheena tweeted it, so yeah, here's the information if I have found it. And what better time to release Wonder Woman when there's not much going on, the Fortnite Batman Zero Point comics have come to an end, and obviously we're just craving content right now. And before I find this last guy and eliminate him, Donald Mustard just revealed a big secret about the Fortnite storyline obviously going forward, especially portrayed on something he drew on one of these Fortnite Batman comic book issues.
Number 5, I drew who you guys know one of her names as, the Singularity. This is a super, super important character. And I can't wait for you to see a bunch of the cool stuff that will be happening with her over the next couple of years. So I hope you enjoy the issues. I hope you enjoy the series, and
I can't wait for everyone to see what happens in issue 5 and then in issue 6 2 weeks from now.
I just played the clip. It's literally 2 seconds later for me, and I've obviously done that through the power of editing, but this boar is looking very suspicious. And yeah, if you don't know who Singularity is, arguably people believe her to have controlled the mecha robot, like literally inside it, defeating the Polar Pete monster in the final showdown, but she was the secret skin this season, and obviously that is only then one of her names, Singularity, out of the snapshots she's created through going through the Zero Points. And yeah, I have a feeling the Fortnite storyline's about to kick into overdrive now, or even be kind of conclusive in terms of the 7 members that are yet to be revealed, all 3 that we don't know of, as we obviously... Oh my god, I nearly just got railgunned. Good job we got the chug cannon. Do your thing. Victory for me! There we go. Empress seems hella happy now. And yeah, in terms of the direction of the storyline, let me know your thoughts on it in the comment section down below, and anything we discussed in today's video. If you enjoyed it, found it helpful or informative, slap a like in it down below. Make sure you subscribe with all notifications turned on so that you don't miss any future uploads with important intel in. And speaking of other videos, make sure to click one of these on screen right now in terms of where you go to when leaving this one. But most importantly, hopefully I can catch you, yes you, in that very next video I do post on the channel.